chapter 37, Genesis, chapter 37.
And Jacob dwelt in the land wherein his father was a stranger, in the land of Canaan. These are the generations of Jacob. Joseph, being 17 years old, was feeding the flock with his brethren. And the lad was with the sons of Bilhah and with the sons of Zilpah, his father's wives. And Joseph brought unto his father the evil report. Now Israel loved Joseph more than all his children, because he was the son of his old age. And he made him a coat of many colors. And when his brethren saw that their father loved him more than all his brethren, they hated him and could not speak peaceably unto him. And Joseph dreamed a dream, and he told his brethren, and they hated him yet the more. And he said unto them, "Hear, I pray you, this dream which I have dreamed. For behold, we were binding sheaves in the field, and lo, my sheaf arose and also stood upright. And behold, your sheaf stood round about and made obeisance to my sheaf." And his brethren said to him, "Shall thou indeed reign over us, or shall thou indeed have dominion over us?" And they hated him yet the more for his dreams and for his words. And he dreamed yet another dream, and told his brethren, and said, "Behold, I have dreamed a dream more, and behold, the sun and the moon and the elephant stars made obeisance to me." And he told it to his father and to his brethren, and his father rebuked him and said unto him, "What is this dream that thou hast dreamed? Shall I and thy mother and thy brethren indeed come to bow down ourselves to thee, to the earth?"
Genesis chapter 37, Genesis chapter 37, Genesis
chapter 37, Genesis
chapter 37.
And his brethren envied him, but his father observed the saying. And his brethren went to feed their father's flock in Shechem. And Israel said unto Joseph, "Do not thy brethren feed the flock in Shechem? Come, and I will send thee unto them." And he said to him, "Here am I." And he said to him, "Go, I pray thee, see whether it be well with thy brethren and well with the flock, and bring me word again." So he sent him out to the vale of Hebron, and he came to Shechem. And a certain man found him, and behold, he was wandering in the field. And the man asked him, saying, "What seekest thou?" And he said, "I seek my brethren. Tell me, I pray thee, where they feed the flocks." And the man said, "They are departed hence, for I heard them say, 'Let us go to Dothan.'" And Joseph went after his brethren and found them in Dothan. And when they saw him afar off, even before he came there unto them, they conspired against him to slay him. And they said one to another, "Behold, this dreamer cometh. Come now therefore, let us slay him and cast him into some pit. And we will say, some evil beast hath devoured him, and we shall see what will become of his dreams." And Reuben heard it, and he delivered him out of their hands, and said, "Let us not kill him." And Reuben said unto them, "Shed no blood, but cast him into this pit that is in the wilderness, and lay no hand upon him, that he might rid him out of their hand, to deliver him to his father again."
Genesis chapter 37, Genesis chapter 37, Genesis
chapter 37, Genesis
chapter 37.
And it came to pass, when Joseph was come unto his brethren, that they stripped Joseph out of his coat, his coat of many colors that was on him. And they took him and cast him into a pit, and the pit was empty, there was no water in it. And they sat down to eat bread, and they lifted up their eyes and looked, and behold, a company of Ishmaelites came from Gilead with their camels bearing spicery and balm and myrrh, going to carry it down to Egypt. And Judah said unto his brethren, "What profit is it if we slay a brother and conceal his blood? Come, let us sell him to the Ishmaelites, and let not our hand be upon him, for he is our brother and our flesh." And his brethren were content. Then there passed by the Midianites merchantmen, and they drew and lifted up Joseph out of the pit, and sold Joseph to the Ishmaelites for 20 pieces of silver. And they brought Joseph into Egypt. And Reuben returned unto the pit, and behold, Joseph was not in the pit, and he rent his clothes. And he returned unto his brethren, and said, "The child is not, and I, whither shall I go?" And they took Joseph's coat, and killed the kid of the goat, and dipped his coat in the blood. And they sent the coat of many colors, and they brought it to their father, and said, "This have we found. Know now whether it be thy son's coat or not." And he knew it, and said, "This is my son's coat. An evil beast hath devoured him. Joseph is without doubt rent in pieces." And Jacob rent his clothes, and put sackcloth upon his loins, and mourned for his son many. And all his sons and all his daughters rose up to comfort him, but he refused to be comforted. And he said, "For I will go down into the grave unto my son mourning." Thus his father wept for him. And the Midianites sold him into Egypt unto Potiphar, an officer of Pharaoh's and captain of the guard.
Genesis chapter 37.